Hello and welcome everyone, this is GeminiMan aka Dante, and I am going to explain to you in this video about how to use GeminiMan WearOS Manager. This is a tool that I have developed that can perform ADB commands from your phone to your WearOS watch. And this tool is not just about sideloading apps or running commands. It can pull applications, it can perform bulk operations such as backing up third-party applications and restoring them. It can debloat application and restore them, and much more. So let's get into this. Let's just go into the WearOS Manager layout. Right, in this layout, you can see an activity log. Now I believe in transparency. I don't want the user just to tap on a button and wait. I want the user to see what is happening under the hood. Everything that you see in the activity log is all the operations being performed. And you'll see that in a bit. Your watch IP address, and there is a question mark. If you tap on the question mark, it will show you a dialog on how to enable watch developer options. Once you enable the watch developer options, ADB debugging and debug over Wi-Fi, you have two options. You either connect your watch to the same network of your phone, or you connect to your phone hotspot, whichever you like. And then you take the IP address that you see on your watch and you enter it in the IP input field. Or if you have the app installed on your watch, you simply tap on Get the Watch IP. Now you can see the activity. It's saying opening the watch and getting network info. I proceed. I've set the IP address and I'm back to idle state. Now you can see that right over here, these all commands and actions, they are unable. You can't tap on any one of those until you connect. So we will connect to the watch. There is a Bluetooth notice. It is recommended that you disconnect, but not necessarily because I have mostly handled everything. So you can proceed with the Bluetooth turned on, but if you find any issues, you can turn off the Bluetooth and try again. So let's just hit I understand, proceed. So the first thing, I'm going to ping the IP to ensure that I'm connected on the same network. I found this IP. Now I'm just putting a notice, keep your eyes on the watch for allow debugging and from select always allow. So I hit the proceed, I look at my watch, I find the prompt, I hit the always allow. Now if you did that once, you don't have to do it again because you have already allowed it always to connect. Right, so there is a dialog notice right over here, delay notice. If you notice a long delay in some operations, wake up your watch screen. Right, so when the watch screen goes off or goes into AOD, there is a big chance that it goes idle, especially if you haven't done any operations for a long time and then you suddenly want to perform some operation while the watch is connected. The watch is in idle state, so it does not really perform anything. So with your hand tilt as a gesture, you wake up the screen of the watch and everything will resume as normal. Or if you press a button also to wake up the watch. The other notice right over here is switching applications. As long as the watch is connected to the application, do not switch between applications. If you do that, the connection will break and the application will restart. And the reason for that is to prevent you guys from going into a state where the application is constantly loading in a frozen state. You can't do anything. You have to force close the application and then start it again. Right, so I had the okay. Now let's have a look at the activity log right over here, guys. So you have connected to the watch, pulling list of applications on the watch. Now you can see that this is a shell command. PM list packages dash F. I'm getting the full details of the packages, which means package name and the path of this package. So I pull this list. Now pulling list of third-party user installed applications, which means any application that is installed from Play Store or sideloaded. Again, full path. Next is pulling the list of installed packages only. So I'm not getting the path anymore. I'm just getting the installed packages on the watch. User and system. And then I'm putting a dash U, which will retrieve all the packages plus anything that I have uninstalled. Or in other words, debloated. All right. And then from these two lists, I'm actually getting the difference, you know? I'm not doing any union, I'm not doing intersection, I'm just subtracting and getting the uninstalled packages. So you can see right over here, successfully pulled the list and generated uninstalled watch applications list. Right. Now we can perform several commands and all. So let's just try with the commands first. So there is a send commands, load existing commands, I will tap on that, and I have an auto-generated list. Now, technically, if you clear this list, all of it, it will say existing commands are empty, generating default commands. So these are default commands that I generated for you because these are most and more frequently used commands. You want to check the screen density, so I'll just say run command only, and you can see right over here, perform command result, physical latency is 340, and you can go ahead and load existing command, and for example, select 200, run command only, and it will just show in here, performed, result done, and then you can proceed. You look at the watch, you find your watch resolution is much smaller right now. So I would say, all right, I would like to reset the density, run command only, and you can literally see that I am actually performing this command, done, my watch is back to being normal density. Right, you can always write your own command. Just remember, you don't type ADB and you don't type shell because this is a shell already direct. So you just write what comes after. You can always, for example, if you want to uninstall something, you don't want to use the debloat option, you can write the package name and then run the command. You can go ahead and say settings, put system phone scale and resize the phone. You can go ahead and pull, for example, you want to pull a file from certain path in your watch, you can do that as well. Right, with that being said, let's just get going to the next part. So we can sideload an APK, so if I would select an APK from here, I can sideload it to the watch. If I would say I would like to pull an APK, so let's just have a look, and I'm going to say I am going to pull, let's just say I am going to pull the watch faces. So I hit the pull, and you can see right over here, the path and everything, successfully pulled the watch application into download, then GeminiMan WearOS Manager, and this is the package APK, cleaning temporary cache. What about, so I don't want to sideload any APK. I don't have any APK to sideload, but basically you select the APK and it'll begin sending the APK to your watch. Let's just say I want to do a backup. First, let me explain this. You have the clear, so you unselect everything. You have load preference. So for example, if I would say I'm going to select these four, and these four, I will always back them up. So instead of backup only, you can save list and backup. If you do that, then basically the next time you hit the load preference, you will load the, what you call, your list of backup applications. You don't have to select them again. For example, I want to select this application, that application, and hit the save and backup. So you can see that now I'm pulling one out of two applications. And success, pulling the second package, pull success, successful pulled two APK files. Now, if I would go ahead and go back up and I say load preference, that is what load preference means. And then if I go, for example, to restore, now I have a file right over here. I just did a backup. So select that, I can choose what I want to restore. And then I hit the restore. What else we have? We've got debloat and reinstall. So let's just go with the debloat, all right? So it shows in here, you have system application, and I put a notice, be careful what you remove, all right? If you remove a system application and your watch starts lagging or crashing, it means that you have removed an essential application. You can try to restore it, but most likely you'll just have to reset the watch because, if the watch is constantly lagging, it's going to be really difficult to connect to and restore. But let's just say that I want to go ahead and debloat some application such as S Health Monitor. So I'm just going to scroll down a bit and try to find it. Just a moment, guys. And in a bit, I will find the S Health monitor. There you go, S Health Monitor. So the same logic that you, if you have a preferred list, let's just say that you have debloated your watch, you've selected the applications, you can save that list. The same way for the backup, you can save that list for the debloat. You reset your watch, you connect to your watch, you say load preference, and then immediately say debloat, and that's pretty much it. So let's just go, I'm going to debloat the S Health Monitor, so I'm just gonna hit that. Uninstalling, PM, sending command, uninstalled successfully. I look at my watch, I can't find S Health Monitor anymore, it's been debloated, so I'm going to say I want to reinstall. The application will say that you have debloated only this application. I select that and I say restore it. The command will show that PM installed existing. Restored application. I look at my watch. There it is. S Health Monitor installed back again. Now, what else do you want to see, guys? Pretty much you have the select APK. So if you want to select or you want to pull an individual APK, you can search right over here. I've already performed this pull. But I'm just showing you that, I forgot to show you that you can search for an individual package. But you can do the same thing right over here. When it comes to, you want to debloat, you cannot search, unfortunately, due to a lot of, let's just say, limitation, because of the complexity of this layout. With that being said, this is pretty much everything that you guys need to know about how this thing works. Now, let's just hit the disconnect. And it will just pop up. Don't forget to turn off ADB debugging and debug over Wi-Fi on your watch. And dismiss. And there you have it, guys. Disconnected from watch. And this is pretty much all the operations that you guys have performed from the time you hit the ADB connect all the way till you disconnected from the watch. Now, there's a message which says, if you're happy, please consider supporting. And I really do appreciate your support, guys. Right, so we go, there is, if you guys want a guide more in details, there is a section for guide. Right now, this video is not the tutorial, I'm just making it right now, and then I'm gonna put it right over here in the tutorial, guys. So this is where you're going to see the tutorial, which I'm actually explaining. And then this is the visual tutorial. Whatever I explain to you guys, it's written in here as a text. So this should be, in a way, helpful for you guys. And as I say, this video is going to change and become the video that I'm actually creating for you guys right now. So by the time you watch it, you're probably not gonna see this video. You're going to actually find the tutorial I'm making for you guys. Thank you very much, guys, for watching and for your time. As I said, you can support me through Google Play, or you can go ahead into PayPal or Patreon. And in here you have an explanation about what are the permissions that are used, for example, network state, to check whether the Wi-Fi is on or not and to perform the ADB commands. You have the Bluetooth connect, so I can pop up the dialog and say, guys, you gotta turn off the Bluetooth or not. Now, the read and write external storage, that's only for Android 9, since I'm supporting Android 9. And the billing, of course, is for you guys to, if you want to support me from here, as in Google Play in-app. And that's pretty much it. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. And I do hope that this application is useful for you guys. Take care.